Today I am going to shoot this Baileys bottle. It's the mini bottle, so not the big one. And this is my setup for now. I know it looks terrible. This space is like big, but it's too small for photography. So first, I use 90mm Tamra macro lens. And I have two wireless triggers. This first one is Yangnuo UN622CTX. It's for under the table over there, this flash, just to get some color on the background, this bit light. Then my other strobes, these are just like my self-made deal solution to papers to get the smooth looking gradient on the bottom. And then I have this to get the key light or the front light to get this etiquette and light up. I'm not sure yet if I use this small softbox or something else to light up it or snoot, but I will see when I get there. So let's get shooting.
Hey, assistant.
Yeah.
Can you please
always put my mind on me? Like the right position, please.
Still waiting.
Assistant. Is that alright for you,
ma'am?
Are you ready?
Madam.
Finally. Now we have this set up. The lights all except the front light to the etiquette to the Baileys. So I need to set up that, and I think our shot is ready. Except I want to drink that. That's the best part. So I have this glass after I have the setup ready. I just pour that in the glass and put these ice cubes in it. Fake ice cubes, because I don't have real ice cubes, I think. So I just use these plastic ones. Looks real enough, right? So I think 4 is better than 2. I think I need to get bigger ones. They're so tiny, but I use this glass, and in Photoshop I put these two photos together, the bottle and this, because I need to open the bottle. And it's not photographable after that. So I photoshop them together and I can drink that after that. So let's get to it. Now I just need to plan my snoot or the front light to it. I need to be careful because I broke my last 90mm lens. Insurance paid me the new one, so that's all fine. But if I'm not really careful, I'm going to break something. So, how to make a snoot? Take A4 paper, or any paper, and that matter. Preferable white, I think. And just do this. You can change the size you want. And you get the snoot, so you can get this tiny light where you want it. This case to the etiquette. And careful. This I'm going to just place on my big strobe and use clamps like these ones, or tape. But this is getting hard if you use it a lot, so the paper may burn, so be careful. I made my snoot. It's this. And it's too powerful with this 300 watt light, so, and the white, it gets through it all the way over there, so this is actually the first time I make my own snoot, so I just will make another one from this. Oops. Blackboard, so the light will get only on the small hole and not like everywhere splashing. this is why I actually bought this and used them as a flag. So let's do the another one snood. This is like cardboard. It's thicker than a paper, so I think this is easier to make, and I can use it in the future too if I make a good one. So let's do it and test it. So I say so like 50 times. So it's easier to make this by yourself. Get the tape on here. Use these small clamps to keep it steady while placing the tape. I use the Jesus tape, as we in Finnish people say, this duct tape, because I just got that one over there, so I just use what I have. I think now it's ready to test it, and I can take this clamp off, because it's taped. Now I will just take a small piece of tape, duct tape, Jesus tape, yellow tape, and it goes smoothly like that, because I used a 10cm thing to test it. I put this tape over here, and just like that it sticks over there, and afterwards I take the tape off, maybe I'll leave it, and I can use this nut on the future too. So now it's ready. Just put the model light on, which is like this, and we have like tape out, clamp off, be careful, and now you see the spot over here, maybe, and it's too big, but at least because this is black, it doesn't get all around it, so let's test it out. And it's too powerful. I need to get the adapter one, this 160 watt lamp over there, because it's like half the power. It's better to use big lights, these small lights, but I only have one working, because the adapter one went to the sea. But no problems, they just paid that too. I think I have a habit to break things. That's why I have a good insurance policy. Now I have this 160 watts Godox and the snoot on it. I've changed the light stand, this smaller one. It's easier to place near where I want it to be. But this is still too powerful. I bet the F8 to 9 and stuff, but then I need to raise other ones' flash power. And I don't want to do that, so I think the snoot idea will go now, because I don't have a less powerful light to use right now. I have a second speed light. I don't know. It is the broken one. It's still capable to flash, but without the transmitter, only with the light hitting the sensor. It's the flash which get broken on the seawater or something. So I can still use this and take it into Photoshop and Photoshop it, I think. I probably make that, because usually it's nice and easier to make it in camera and all like this light you use. But in this case I think the Photoshop is easier and faster for me. So I will just do it in Photoshop instead. I just decided just to use the original solution, the small softbox, like 60 to 40 centimeters, because, and back to the 300 and the lowest power, because it just gets the smoother, softer light to the front of the etiquette here, and because of that, it gets this flare and stuff on the bottle, but it's a black bottle, so I think it's just easy to Photoshop. Maybe it's clear bottle like wine or something, white wine, or I don't know, something else, like this penis kumquat liqueur bottle from Greece. I think it will get harder to light up the small kumquat etiquette. And it will get flares all around it because of these details, these balls and stuff. So this case it's easier just to Photoshop that you get there and cut out all the reflections and stuff, flares. In this case you can do it too, just cut that out and place back here like gold board or something to get this glow on the liquor yellow. But this case it's black bottle, it's easier, so let's go the easier solution, not the hard way around like I usually do, like you actually just saw. Well, without like learning stuff, you never learn. So lesson learned, make the first intuition you have and test that first. And just Photoshop if you can, it's easier. Okay, now I have the shot with the yellowish color grade on the grey background. I have the light on the both sides. I have the like key light on the etiquette, which I Photoshop. And now I have the glass. I positioned it like I wanted to be, and I actually changed just focused it on the glass, because otherwise it's just a little bit not clear enough. So I think it's nothing big to edit in Photoshop in the post. So now I can open this, because I have the bottle in with the glass. It's like a noon and I'm getting drunk. Is that enough? That's probably enough. Close it. Now you see it's open. Probably you can edit this too in Photoshop if you want. But I have the clear bottle now. I tried to place it where it was, but I don't need to, because I just used the bottle that I had in photos of these two pictures together in merch. So actually I may take it out and just take my photo without it. My knees hurt. You get your exercise when you take photos. Now, I have the photo over here, and it's otherwise good, but the liquid needs just a hint of light, so let's see if this doesn't get me bad, like bad reflections, flares, okay? It gives me the reflections, but I can edit the liquid now. It's just more Photoshop work. Now I'm happy with it. Now I can drink it and put all this stuff away. I just wanted to get my studio ready. I am making my own studio. This is just temporary. When I get it ready, I have more space and I can just leave all like it is and continue next time I take a photo shoot. Let's taste how cold it is in these plastic ice cubes. Just to let you guys know that I haven't eaten anything yet, so this is my breakfast. And Baileys didn't sponsor this or anything. I sponsored it by myself. So that was it. This was the setup. You see the photos while I took them. I think I post them somewhere on this video. You probably seen them already. I'm not. I'm just still have all this to edit, which you just saw. So if you want to get me anything back on my efforts to make this video, amateur video, just subscribe. Thanks, and see you on the next vlog.